Hello everyone, my name is Anton and this is my first vlog-like video, and it's going to be about the hobby project I currently work on. Some time ago, when I was working as a web developer, I started to feel dissatisfied with the fact that the code I write doesn't affect the real world in any meaningful way. Of course, there are a lot of software-only projects that impact the real world, but I decided to take the most straightforward approach and dive into robotics. So I read some articles on the topic, some books, watched some videos, bought soldering equipment and a 3D printer. When I was a kid, I could only dream of having a 3D printer because at that time it seemed like some science fiction thing capable of making physical shapes out of imagination. And now they are relatively cheap and easily available and can spare me burden of making parts out of food containers and similar junk. My first robot was this caterpillar thing, made out of a couple of motors, some electronic components, a power bank and a Raspberry Pi as its brain. I designed parts in Blender and then printed them. If you do something like this, please don't repeat my mistakes and don't use artistic 3D software for making mechanical parts, and instead invest a day or two into learning basics of some parametric 3D software, as it is much more suitable for making parts with strict dimensions. In the process of making this thing, I encountered one problem. When I assembled everything, motors were barely moving. It turned out I mixed up collector and emitter of transistors, and after soldering them, everything started to work. It's hard to call this thing a robot because it doesn't do anything on its own and is only remotely controlled. But anyway, I felt great about making it, believed in myself, and decided to make the same thing, but a flying one. After some research, I decided to use some conventional for quadcopter parts, such as brushless motors, electronic speed controllers, and a LiPo battery capable of providing high current to the motors. As for the brain, I still used the same Raspberry Pi. After I found out how to interface Raspberry Pi with electronic speed controllers, I started to design the frame to hold all the parts. I was doing that still in Blender and relying only on intuition in hope that requirements for a frame are not very strict, because I saw drones of such weird shapes that were still able to fly. I also bought a board incorporating a gyroscope, accelerometer, barometer and magnetometer on the I2C bus. Before I even learned what PID controller is, my first intuitive approach was similar to the way the P term works. Just increase or decrease motor speed proportionally to the angle the drone derives from horizontal plane. In the beginning, I thought that it wouldn't be a very difficult task, but after all the failed attempts, I had no idea how to do this the right way, because there are so many things that may not work properly. And contrary to making something software only, every run may end up with physical damage, and the next try will be possible only after damaged parts are replaced. Also, it's not that easy to test this thing in a small rented flat. Had I had a big garage, shed or something like this, I could make a construction that would restrict the drone motion, but instead I had to improvise and use shoelaces and my own hands, which sometimes led to minor but unpleasant injuries. At some point I thought that it's not convenient to control the drone with mouse and keyboard, and decided to make a controller app where I can change parameters, monitor sensor readings and gradually control the drone with analog-like UI. Initially, for some reason, I focused on horizontal leveling control, just to realize that I cannot safely test it, and what I need more is automatic height control. My first thought was to use barometer readings, but they were not precise enough to control height indoors. Or maybe I just used them in the wrong way, so I bought an ultrasonic sensor in a local electronic component shop. Actually, it had a weird interface which turns one of the pins high during the measurement, and you have to count time to deduce the distance. When the Raspberry Pi was relatively idle, it worked fine, but under the computational load, it just missed timings and the readings were garbage. So I had to add additional AVR controller to the project solely to measure these timings and output results in convenient digital form on SPI interface. I also bought these two bicycle braid cables and printed these guides to restrict the motion of a drone to only up and down, so I could focus on height control without thinking about controlling other degrees of freedom. And it kinda worked, except for the case when the propellers were working, creating turbulence which interfered with ultrasonic sensor readings at heights above 40 centimeters. When I finally found it out, I had to replace ultrasonic sensor with a laser one. At that point, I already had height control, but still couldn't achieve stable horizontal leveling. I guessed several reasons for it, and I'm not sure which of them contributed to the problem the most, but here they are. The first one, and probably the most significant, I used cheap propellers and even tried to print them and neglected the necessity to balance them, which in turn overloads IMU sensors with noise, which reduces their precision. When I finally decided to address this issue, I added a feature to my app to take last 100 gyroscope readings and output range between the biggest and the smallest value. The bigger the range when propeller is working, the more unbalanced it is. I randomly stick duct tape to blades of propellers, then run them to check the value. If it's increased, probably a bad place to stick there. If the noise is decreased, I'm on the right path. Then I try to stick it further or closer to the center and check again. So this way I reduce the noise on each propeller. The second possible issue that the Raspberry Pi has only two PWM channels, but there are four ECs controlled with it, and software PWM may not be precise enough and also wastes CPU cycles. So I decided to use ESP32 for this task, because they are cheap, easily available and have a lot of interfaces which Raspberry Pi lacks. I started with controlling ESCs through ESP32 connected with Raspberry Pi over SPI and ended up moving all the flight controller logic to ESP32. The third issue was probably not a rigid enough frame, which I redesigned and printed several times. Somewhere in the development process, I got frustrated with the amount of wires between the modules and the way they were placed, so I decided to invest some time in the skill of making custom PCBs. I thought about it for a long time, but was discouraged by the necessity of buying expensive tools and dealing with chemicals. Actually, it turned out easier than I thought. I watched some tutorials on KiCad to create the design of my PCB, I bought a second-hand laser printer for 40 bucks, I also bought a regular iron without holes for 5 bucks, and the most expensive tool was a drilling press for 75 bucks. The chemicals turned out not to be so dangerous, they won't dissolve your skin if you touch them. So I made this PCB on the fourth attempt. The hardest part was actually to apply solder mask. What this PCB does is that it interconnects sensors, ESP32, Raspberry Pi, and delivers appropriate voltage to different parts. In the app, I made fancy charts which show current sensor readings, which in practice turned out to be difficult to analyze while trying to prevent your drone from crashing. So I added the ability to record the sensor data and wrote a Python script to analyze it frame by frame with the video record of the flight. Had I done this earlier, I would have spent much less time investigating problems caused by a faulty ultrasonic sensor, which I mentioned previously. At some point, I achieved relatively stable height, direction, and horizontal leveling control, but still couldn't avoid horizontal drifting. And if someone knows, is it possible to get rid of horizontal drifting using only IMU sensor, please let me know in the comments. I did some research and found out that some drones use GPS for position hold and try to implement the same technique, but the problem is that it works only outside, but even outside, I couldn't achieve any satisfactory results. The weather was terrible that season, with wind, rain and snow, so I didn't make many attempts, bailed with the GPS and tried a computer vision approach. I placed a camera to the bottom of the drone and tried to hold this blue mark on the floor using OpenCV library. After several attempts at tweaks, here the result.
Finally, it can hover in one point without manual control and without any strings. Of course, it's not a practical solution to hover over the blue mark, but it gives me hope that now it's stable enough to be controlled by visual data.
I also added transfer of a video stream from the drone to the app, so now I can experiment with computer vision to try different approaches to make general position hold and other features.
This is how it's made right now. This ESP32 is responsible for height, direction and leveling control. It takes data from IMU sensors and the laser distance sensor on the bottom. It gives commands to motor controllers and also it takes commands from Raspberry Pi, which itself is responsible for communication with the app and position control using data from the camera. I didn't solder these chips directly to my custom PCB, because it's not a finished design, and this way it's easy to make changes with low risk of damaging components by heat. Also, I'm not that advanced to solder QFN chips like this IMU and make PCBs with such tiny paths yet.
If someone's interested to see the code, the link to my GitHub in the description. I'm not gonna post regularly, and the next thing I will post may be on absolutely different topic. But if you like what I do, subscribe to my channel, my Instagram, leave a comment and press thumbs up. And peace everyone!